He's loved by many.
Oh, you must be talking about me. Yes, it's true.
And respected by our community like few others before him.
Wait, seriously? I'm touched. I feel so honored.
No, not you.
Who is beloved more than me, peasant?
Henry Hinton. This is Talk of the Town.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Hey, welcome back. It's hour two of Talk of the Town here this morning on 103.7 WTIB. Nice to have you here. It's 5 minutes after eight. Henry Hinton and Trent McGee and Heather King with you this morning live on the radio from the Radio Ranch. How you guys doing?
Good to see you. Fine. Good to see you.
We got Panthers of football tonight. And for you folks in Edenton, we have Edenton Aces football tonight. Unfortunately, we will not be able to carry the Edenton High School game tonight on 103.7 because of the Panthers game, and they keep moving these high school games around. They moved that Currituck Edenton game to tonight. So we will be streaming it, as I understand it, on WTIBFM.com. WTIBFM.com, our website, will have the audio stream for Edenton and Currituck tonight. So Tommy Bass will be calling the action from up there tonight in Currituck County, but unfortunately no radio coverage because we got the Panthers and the Steelers. And the Panthers and the Steelers will play tonight in an NFL game. What time do they kick off, man? I hope it's earlier so I can watch some of it.
8:20.
I'll see the first half. It's just too late for you and me, isn't it, Heather?
I mean, I was in bed at 8:45 last night.
But, I mean, let's be honest.
I don't even have to get up that early.
You get to sleep now until what time?
I usually get up around 5:15.
5:15.
I got to get up earlier than the kids. I got to beat the kids. And with daylight saving time, not easy.
Yeah. I heard that. But, you know, the thing about it is lighter in the morning now.
Yes.
But it won't be in a couple of weeks.
It won't be.
Probably next week. It'll probably, yeah.
Yeah. They're up early. Yeah. They're ready to go.
Exactly.
Hey, Mom.
Lauren gives me grief if I'm in bed by 8:45 or 9 o'clock. I'm like, honey, I'm tired tonight. It's like 8:15. I'm like, I got to go to bed. She's like, what are you, like a 70-year-old man? I'm like,
oh, really?
Hey, I resemble that.
I know. That's what I said. Look at Henry.
Well, I mean, when you get up at 5 in the morning, I get up at 5 every morning.
Yeah. That's what I tell her.
When you get up at 5 in the morning, I mean, look, I'm in pretty good shape for a 65-year-old. But I'm still tired when I want to go to bed. Mm-hmm. I just go to bed.
Yeah.
But, you know, last night I didn't go to bed until after 10, so, which is very unusual for me.
That's
but
late
I had,
for you.
Had the ECU Business School dinner last night, which we talked about last hour. The smartest kids on the planet. They're going to do such great things when they leave here. It's amazing. I'm so proud of them. And I was thinking last night when I was sitting there with these kids, I mean, you know, they don't know who's on the Board of Governors or who's on the Board of Trustees. They don't care. You know what? They're there to get an education and to have their college experience, and then they'll move on in life and do great things. And so, you know, everybody gets so worked up about stuff.
Everything.
And, you know, we talked about the football last night.
They care about that?
Well, the kid from New Jersey actually told me he came down to go to ECU because of football. He said, I came down here in high school, went to a college football game. We were ranked in the top 25. He said, I thought it was going to be like that the whole time. I said, well, it's going to be like that again sometime.
Yeah.
But they all, you know, but you know, it's interesting. All of the kids sitting there, only one of the six kids at my table had gone to the game last week.
Oh, I believe that.
And I was scolding him for that. but again, 3 of 6 listen to Interbanks Media radio stations, and I was proud of that for all of you people who say that millennials don't listen to radio. That by the way, is just not true, because everything we see in the Nielsen ratings, the numbers get bigger. People all over the country still. And let me tell you, college kids listening to the radio. One of them last night telling me they listen to 107.9 because she loves the classic. Well, she put it as classic rock, but it's classic hits. And we had one that listens to our sports stuff. He loves Dan Patrick on 94.3 The Game. and one listens to Fresh 97.9.
I'm grappling with the fact that I also love 107.9. And I'm like, man, that was like my favorite song 20 years ago.
Back then,
and now it's classic.
I know. Well, I mean, to be honest with you, our programming people have done that on purpose.
Yeah.
They're targeting you.
Well, they target
They're targeting well. 25, 54-year-old women and men, but...
They got me, too. You
know, I love that station.
Yeah, yeah. And our morning team over there.
Oh.
When I put them together, I thought they'd be good. I didn't think they'd be this good. They may be hurting my ratings.
They're hilarious. They really are.
Hey, as long as you're listening to one of our stations, that's all that matters.
There you go.
Coming up Saturday night in Roanoke Rapids, it's the big event, the real grand opening of the Roanoke Rapids Theater, the re-grand opening of that theater up there that's been through a lot of changes. But my friend Tom McLean has bought it, and he's got some really big things coming. And I hope people will support what's going on. But he's got a big act coming up Saturday night. The opening act, the grand reopening, is the Charlie Daniels Band. And, by the way, we were trying to get an interview with Charlie Daniels, and we couldn't work out the time. So, once again, being the team player that I am, I was able to work it out for Tom and Sadie to interview Charlie Daniels tomorrow. So, Charlie, you know, we've had Charlie on the show before, but Charlie Daniels will be on Tom and Sadie on 103.7 and 96.3 on Friday afternoon. So you can tune in and hear the great Charlie Daniels. But this morning we've got the owner, the great Tom McLean, is going to be here to talk about the grand opening weekend coming up. All right, what have we missed this morning? Oh, here's something interesting. Did you guys see this? This is a big news story in China. We were talking earlier this morning about one of our listeners, our faithful Facebook viewer, Charlie Chambers, who was listening to us and watching us in Shanghai this morning while it was 8:15 on Thursday night in China. This is a true story coming out of China. This broke yesterday, newsflare.com. And again, I'd like for my advertising sales staff to hear this story, okay? Here's just think, you could be working in China. A Chinese company forced its sales staff to drink urine and eat cockroaches after they failed to meet their sales targets. The video, filmed in Zunai City in western Guizhou province, China, shows a male worker standing in the middle of the room being whipped by a woman. And by the way, there's another young man that gets up there, and he's whipped with a whip by another man. There's video. I've seen the video. It's pretty shocking stuff. Since the employees, then several employees were seen to be made to take a cup of yellow liquid from a table and drink it up, thought to be urine. Since the employees failed to reach the sales targets, they received various nauseating punishments, including drinking urine and eating cockroaches. Here's the thing. You would say in China anything goes, right? Because human rights in China, they don't pay much attention to that. But the company has actually had three of their managers indicted and arrested on this. They have been detained for 10 days and 5 days, respectively, while the case is being investigated, according to reports. If you have not seen the video of this and you want to see it, go to Newsflare. McGee, there it is. McGee is watching the video. Now watch, they have these young sales guys, and then they have other people coming up and whipping them with a whip. And then they're made to drink urine.
That's ridiculous. I can't. The whipping part I can watch, not the urine part.
Yeah. I worked for a company that was pretty tough if you didn't make your sales goals. And you might get mentally whipped around a little bit. But you didn't actually get whipped with a whip. That's crazy stuff.
That is.
Let's see. What else have we got this morning that I missed? Today is there's just not many celebrity birthdays today. Today is November 8th. The biggest celebrity birthday I have is Gordon Ramsay. He's the chef. He's the crazy screaming chef, Gordon Ramsay. Tara Reid is 43, and Jack Osborne is 33. Somebody explain to me why Jack Osborne is a celebrity.
When they had their own show.
I know, but what did he do? He was just a goofy teenage kid. Why does people care? Because reality TV really is a thing? Is that the thing? We announced yesterday the charities that would be receiving the money from the Avett Brothers concert, which is now coming up on Tuesday night. We did confirm yesterday some members of the Carolina Panthers staff are going to be here. Probably no players because the travel schedule, we've got a bad break on that. We didn't announce it, but we were told a couple weeks ago that a couple of high-profile Carolina Panthers players were coming to the concert Tuesday night here in Greenville. And because they play tonight on Thursday night, Coach Rivera's changed the practice schedule, and so they're practicing Tuesday and Wednesday. So now we're going to have some representatives. And we may have a surprise representative from the Carolina Panthers here on Tuesday night to present their check for $25,000. We announced yesterday the charities that will benefit from the Avett Brothers concert on Tuesday night, the Food Bank of Central and Eastern North Carolina, the New Bern Relief Fund, the nonprofit in Jones County named Rise, which is raising money to try to help people rebuild in the Jones County, and the Onslow Community Outreach in Jacksonville, and RAFI, which is the Rural Advancement Foundation International. Because of the Avett Brothers' knowledge of farming and their support for family farmers, the band wanted to ensure that farmers impacted by Hurricane Florence got the aid they need, and so we're giving money to the farmers through the RAFI organization as well, which, by the way, is an offshoot of Farm Aid. We are very excited about it. There are tickets left for the show. There are tickets left for the dinner before the show. By the way, I found out yesterday the Vivian Howard dinner has been moved to Harvey Hall inside the Murphy Center between the stadium and the arena. Now, we were originally told that the dinner with Vivian Howard, Sam Jones, and Joe Quan of the Avett Brothers was going to take place in the club level at the stadium, but no, that's not right. Apparently, there's a conflict, and yesterday the university announced that it would be moved to Harvey Hall in the Murphy Center. Tickets for that are $100 each. You will be treated to a dinner, as you heard Vivian Howard and Sam Jones say earlier this week, food prepared by Vivian and Sam Jones. And it's going to be, as Vivian put it, it's going to be a floating affair. Joe Quan of the Avett Brothers is going to be there. And it's $100 a ticket. It starts at 4 o'clock in the afternoon. So it's an early start for that on Tuesday. It's $100 a ticket. And I've got, if you go to my Facebook page, Henry Hinton on Facebook, you can find a link to buy the tickets to the dinner. McGee, you got that on our regular Facebook?
Yep.
I think you do.
Mm-hmm.
And then there's a link also to buy tickets for the Avett Brothers concert. The only tickets left are upstairs now. They're $65. And we need to sell this thing out because, our goal is to give about $250,000 to these charities to help rebuild Eastern North Carolina after Hurricane Florence. So please buy a ticket to the Avett Brothers. And, yes, we have announced the Embers Christmas show is coming back to Greenville on December 9th. Going to be in the same place as last year, thanks to the great folks at Re-Image Church, Pastor Chris and Tara and the whole group at Re-Image Church here in Greenville. If you miss the Embers Christmas show next year, I am ordering you to go this year. And by the way, all the ticket sales from that show will go to Operation Santa Claus. We're giving away all the money from the ticket sales on both of these big shows. So the Embers Christmas show, December 9th, and that's a Sunday night. It'll start at 7 o'clock. It is absolutely the best thing you could do for your family this Christmas to take your family, the whole family, to see this show. Because it is one of the best things about Christmas. It should become a Christmas tradition for everybody, I think. Craig Willard is such an incredible entertainer. It's not a beach music show. It's all family favorite traditional beach music songs and Christmas hymns performed by Craig Willard and the Embers. And if you hadn't seen it, it's that good. You got to come see it. And, of course, Santa Claus shows up, Frosty the Snowman, and Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer show. It's a family-friendly deal. And tickets are $20, and 100% of the ticket sales. We don't keep a dime. The church doesn't take anything. 100% of the ticket sales go to the Operation Santa Claus efforts, which, of course, is something that we have been involved in for many, many years here because we love that charity because all of the toys stay local. They're not shipped out anywhere, and they stay here. Every single dime that's raised goes towards buying tickets and goes more toward buying toys for the kids here locally. I'm looking for my list of Ember sponsors, and if I don't find it, I'm going to be choked at sunset.
Maybe whipped.
I had them right here.
Maybe forced to drink urine.
Ooh.
I don't know. Find them. Find them.
I cannot believe I can't find. Just hang on a second. Everybody just be patient with me a little bit.
It is a great show, though. I encourage you. If you haven't been.
I'm a little older. Here we go. Thanks to our Embers Christmas Show sponsors here in Greenville, Suddenlink, Greenville Utilities, TAF Office Equipment, and Steinbeck's Men's Shop. And by the way, Steinbeck's is going to be selling tickets. I don't think they've got them yet, but that might actually happen today. I'll let you know. You can actually, if you don't want to buy your tickets online, you can actually go get a ticket in your hand at Steinbeck's Men's Shop. But thanks to J. Hugh Taff at Taff Office, Frank and Tilden at Steinbeck's Men's Shop. Thanks to the folks at Suddenlink, and thanks to Tony Cannon and the folks at Greenville Utilities for being our Embers Christmas Show sponsors. And, of course, the sponsors allow us to pay all the expenses and pay the band and the whole deal for coming and entertaining us like that. And it allows us to give all the money to charity from the ticket sales. All right, Talk of the Town this morning brought to you in part by our friends at University PC Care. Since 2006, University PC has been the area's leading IT service provider with a focus on quality repairs at affordable prices and is one of the only Apple-authorized service providers in the area. University PC Care is the place to go for peace of mind, knowing that only highly trained Apple-certified staff will complete your Apple repairs. When you've got a problem with your Mac, iPhone, or iPad, you know who to call in Greenville and New Bern. It's University PC Care. Go to universitypccare.com and learn more. Call them locally here in Greenville at 252-558-1280, 252-558-1280. All right, 21 after 8 o'clock, we've got Heather King from WITN in here this morning. And coming up, we got news, weather, and sports, and also news about the big opening night at Roanoke Rapids Theater with Charlie Daniels coming up on Saturday night right after the break. Stay with us. We'll be right back.
Don't wait. Get year-end savings now at Greenville Toyota. Corollas, $159 a month. RAV4s, $199. The wait is over and the deals won't last. It's the year-end savings event at Greenville Toyota, where our volume saves you money.
All right, everybody. This is our team. This is our house. Now let's go out there and have some fun. Ready?
Ready!
Hi, I'm Luke Keekley. And just like my team, Pepsi was born right here in the Carolinas. This is our home field, and Pepsi is dedicated to making a positive impact in the communities all across our two great states. So here's to our house, the Carolinas.
U.S. Cellular put towers where most others don't. So people can schedule a chiropractor visit out here. Or catch the game live. Way over here. Isn't that what you pay for? A stronger signal in the middle of anywhere.
Visit Real Wireless, your local U.S. Cellular authorized agent in Ahoskie, Williamston, and Windsor for the best deals in wireless and great service on a network that works in the middle of anywhere.
The ECU Foundation, in association with Interbanks Media, is proud to present the Avett Brothers, sponsored by the Carolina Panthers. Brothers headlining concert for Hurricane Florence Relief, Minji's Coliseum, Tuesday, November 13th. Tickets are on sale now at ecutickets.net and by phone at 800-DIAL-ECU. Proceeds we donated back to the people and organizations contributing to Hurricane Florence relief efforts. The Avett Brothers, brought to you by the ECU Foundation and Interbanks Media.
Carolina's greatest hits play all day on 107.9 WNCT.
Don't stop believing.
In the morning. Carolina's greatest hits play here.
WNCT.
You waited for year-end savings. Now it's finally here at Greenville Toyota. Camrys, only $179 a month. You don't want to miss these deals. Camrys, $179 during the year-end savings event at Greenville Toyota.
keeping you ahead of the story.
This is your Eastern Carolina News Update.
Good morning with your WITN News Update. I'm Heather King. The Ventura County Sheriff's Office says 13 people are dead, including a sheriff's sergeant and the gunman who opened fire at a Southern California bar. The Ventura County Sheriff's Office said the first reports of shots fired came at 11:20 p.m. at the Borderline Bar and Grill in Thousand Oaks, which is about 40 miles west of Los Angeles. Authorities say a responding deputy was shot and taken to a hospital. No other information on the victims, was immediately known. The bar's website says it hosts College Country Night every Wednesday. Police said hundreds were inside when the shooting occurred. The trial for a man who was arrested outside of a Waffle House in early May is expected to begin today. The case has gained national attention after Warsaw police officer Frank Moss was seen putting his hand on Anthony Wall's throat and putting him on the ground in what became a viral video. Officer Moss responded to the restaurant in Duplin County after getting complaints that Wall had gotten into an argument with people inside. Attorneys for Wall say the staff had directed homophobic slurs at him. Wall was charged with disorderly conduct and resisting arrest. His trial is expected to begin today after being delayed while the FBI investigated whether or not Officer Moss used excessive force. Come tomorrow, the shelter at the New Bern Rec Center, the final shelter in operation following Hurricane Florence, will close for good. Before it does, the Department of Housing and Urban Development has been finalizing finding homes for people. According to the Red Cross, the number of people staying at the New Bern shelter Wednesday was expected to be fewer than 20, down from more than 100 people living there in mid-October. After winning the lottery on Monday, one woman says she'll use her prize money to repair her storm-damaged home. Shirley Tolson of Robeson County says she'll use the nearly $106,000 she pocketed from a scratch-off prize for repairs after her roof and chimney were damaged in Hurricane Florence. Her home was also damaged by Hurricane Matthew in 2016. She says she rarely plays the lottery but took a chance on impulse buying a $5 scratch-off ticket. She ended up winning $150,000 and takes home about $106,000 after taxes. The city of Greenville today is hosting its annual chili cook-off at Greenville Fire Station No. 1. About 20 businesses, individuals, and fire stations are entering pots of chili in the competition. The bowls of chili will be $5 or $8 for all you can eat. There will also be hot dogs, banana pudding, and baked goods up for a silent auction. Meals will be served from 11:30 a.m. until 2 p.m. Fire Station No. 1 is at 500 South Green Street in Uptown Greenville, and all proceeds benefit the United Way of Pitt County. Those are your WITN News headlines. I'm Heather King.
Cloudy, cool, and breezy for your Thursday with highs in the low 60s. A rain chance about 20% for today. Tonight we'll see cloudy skies with a stray raindrop possible. Lows around 50 degrees. Friday, mostly cloudy skies with highs reaching around 70. And the rain moving out for the weekend looking much better with sunny skies both Saturday and Sunday with highs in the low to mid 50s.
Hey, today is the day for the big party here in town. Are you going? The Gatsby party today. We've been talking about it for weeks at Beauty Bar Medi Spa. Every year, here in Greenville, Beauty Bar has a big party to celebrate another year of making friends, and they call it their Gatsby affair. And it's going on today, from 11 to 7. At Beauty Bar Medi Spa, they're going to have Gatsby-style refreshments and prices so low you're going to feel like you're back in the 20s. They know what you want to look and feel your best, especially around the holidays, so save money, get their procedures and services for less. Absolutely everything on sale for this one-day-only event. Make sure to mark your calendar for Thursday, November 8th, for the Beauty Bar Medi Spa Gatsby affair. It is today. They'll have free consultations all day long today, 11 to 7. So and the free all sorts of free refreshments and things like that, and they also going to have great prices today. So look your best this holiday season. Take advantage of the lowest prices of the year on McGee Botox. Good prices today on Botox, filler, body contouring, medical grade skincare products and services. That is today, 11 to 7, Red Banks Road. What are you laughing at? You think I need the Botox? Is that what you're saying?
Do I need it? I mean, you asked me like I needed it. Maybe I do.
Well, you could use a little filler.
I could.
By the way, what is filler?
I'm not
Heather?
Offended by that, by the way.
Heather, what is filler?
Does your face look better?
Oh, well, I definitely need that.
Well, no, I'm definitely offended by it.
That's the annual Gatsby affair going on today at Beauty Bar Medi Spa, 29 after 8. My friend Tom McLean from the Roanoke Rapids Theater has his big opening night coming up. He's got Charlie Daniels coming to town this weekend. We'll talk about that. One thing before we let you go, you mentioned this yesterday. There was a lot of talk yesterday. I am hearing that there could be a complaint filed about this flyer that went around to the ECU campus fraternity and sorority houses, and apparently a bunch of people on Fifth Street also got this flyer. It was, let's see if I can find this here. Someone wrote a flyer that said, and by the way, it was anonymous. It was not signed by anyone, but as my understanding, there is video and surveillance video of the lady that did this. And this is what it said. Again, you know, you tell me, is this an effort to suppress or discourage voting by the students? It says, notice to Greek life students. If you have been offered rides and limos and other bribes in exchange for voting for certain candidates, this is to notify you that this is illegal, that it's being investigated, and you could hurt your fraternity's tax status if you participate in illegal partisan voting activity. You have a right to vote, but it needs to be above board. Don't be used. Now, you know, we saw some of this in the municipal elections last year here in Greenville. There were women and other supporters of certain city council candidates, particularly in the mayor's race, I think, that were going up to students in cars and that were being offered rides and saying, you're not supposed to be offered a ride to vote. And have you been paid? Has someone paid you? Alleging that because that they had been that some of the students had been given rides to the polls, that they were being bribed in some way. Well, you know, there are a lot of folks that believe that this is potential voter suppression. In fact, a university professor who is a political science professor says, let's see, make sure I got the right one here, posted on Facebook, he said, this is an attempt at voter suppression from people who claim to deplore voter suppression efforts. ECU students, please vote without fear of reprisal. Ignore this pathetic voter suppression effort. And now that came from a university professor who got very upset that this was being distributed all over the neighborhood around the university. And so, you know, this guy makes a good point. These are the same people that scream, voter ID is voter suppression. They're the same people that, you know, say, you know, well, the conservative voters are trying to keep people from voting for Democrats and all that. And then you've got somebody walking around in Greenville threatening the students and basically saying, you know, putting them on notice that, you know, they'll lose their fraternity might get shut down or they lose their tax-exempt status. And because, you know, there is nothing illegal about voting, about people being taken to the polls to vote. If it was, I mean, look at all the churches on these Sunday voting days that tell their congregation, here's how you vote. Now let's go have lunch in the assembly hall, and then, by the way, we've got buses waiting outside to take you to the polls. Am I right, Coach? What's the difference in doing that and taking fraternities and sororities and offering them a ride to the poll? And you know, I checked on this last night. I said, did someone offer these guys a ride in a limo? And the answer to that was no. But, again, this thing everybody in Greenville ought to be disturbed by this. And, you know, if there's going to be a petition filed with the Board of Elections on this, it'll be interesting to see if the person that did it is willing to come out and explain why she did it. They've got video of her, and now you got a college professor who's jumped in on the act saying, you know, this is voter suppression. And that's what it looks like to me. 8:34, thank you, Heather, for being here.
You're welcome.
Talk to you soon.
All righty.
Let's get a break in. We'll come back with news about Charlie Daniels coming to Eastern North Carolina on Saturday. Be right back.
Save with low monthly payments on new Jeep. here at East Carolina Chrysler Dodge Jeep.
It's the Black Friday sales event. Lease a new 2019 Jeep Cherokee for only $299 a month. With only $299 due at signing. Lease a new Jeep Grand Cherokee for only $399 a month. With only $399 due at signing. Or lease a new Jeep Wrangler for only $399 a month. With only $399 due at signing.
Across from the Cracker Barrel in Greenville.
Carolina's greatest hits play all day on 107.9 WNCT.
Don't stop believing. Give it all a breath.
All your favorites.
Just like the ocean on the
with Mark, Mark, and Laura in the morning.
You can go your own way.
Carolina's greatest hits play here.
WNCT.
This is the Pepsi for serious fans. Mmm. And serious eats. Oh, yeah. Like Carolina pulled pork, carnitas, or Alberto's al pastor. Nice, Beto. This is the Pepsi for Sundays at the ballpark and days off at your favorite joint. Whatever you're craving, this is the Pepsi for you.
Stop by Moore's Old Time Barbecue and grab a Carolina Classic combo with a free 20-ounce Pepsi. Moore's Barbecue and Pepsi, Carolina Classics indeed.
How I define making, in the broadest possible terms, it is making something extant in the world that didn't exist. Everybody who's ever made anything is bringing something into fruition for a reason. And that act in and of itself makes us stewards of our culture. It's something that we're talking about. It's a response. Actually, it's telling a story. That's really what it is. And I include everything that could be made, painting, sculpture, welding, all of that.
Yellow is positive.
When a kid gets their hands on the world and learns that they can make their fantasy play, that they can make their reality, that's power. And as far as I'm concerned, everyone should feel that kind of power. There we go. If there's something that interests you to bring into the world, that's fantastic. Go figure out how to do it. Go tell your own story. There it is. And so I want to know why you make. Let's go.
Share your own Why I Make story today. Visit whyimake.org.
Come check out the all-new 2019 Ram. We have a huge selection to choose from here at East Carolina Chrysler Dodge Jeep.
Hurry in to the Black Friday sales event for huge rebates and super low lease payments on Ram trucks. Right now, get a total savings of $12,659 or lease a new 2019 Ram 1500 Crew Cab for only $379 a month with only $999 due at signing.
Across from the Cracker Barrel in Greenville.
A 37, 23 minutes in front of 9 o'clock, and we've been talking about all this great entertainment coming to Eastern North Carolina, and there is an entertainment venue about to open in Eastern North Carolina. It's everything that's old is new again. It's the Roanoke Rapids Theater, but this time I have faith because I know the guy that's going to be running the show. My buddy Taco Tom McLean is live in the studio. Tom McLean, local businessman here in Greenville, an old golfing buddy of mine, and Tom has been very successful in business. For those of you who don't know, last time we were on, we talked about it. I think he owned every Taco Bell east of Raleigh at one point, in Myrtle Beach, and pretty close, right?
Not a lot of them, but not every one of
them. Enough for us to start calling you Taco Tom.
Well, they couldn't remember my real name.
But Tom is now out of the taco business and into the entertainment business as the new owner of the Roanoke Rapids Theater, and this is a big weekend because you got your opening night coming up on Saturday night and a big act coming.
It is big, and we are very excited about it.
Yeah.
Charlie Daniels, of course, is going to be there. He is a native North Carolinian, and it's Veterans Day weekend, and he is a big supporter of veterans. We're also having a cake, and we're having ribbon cutting, and we're having on Saturday to for it being the grand opening, and we're having a cake because it's the 243rd birthday of the U.S. Marine Corps.
Awesome.
Since 1775.
Right.
And
Have you got your restaurant open yet? Last time you here, you said you were working on getting the restaurant open.
It's going to open on Monday officially. We had we did have some staffing problems and equipment problems and permitting problems. not so much problems, but just issues. You know, issues that you don't anticipate.
So what kind of restaurant will it be? Is it a sports bar kind of a concept?
Pretty much so. We're going to have, of course, we'll be serving beer and wine. And we have, wings and fries and sandwiches, flatbread sandwiches.
Kind of a cool sports bar concept.
We hope so.
And so Charlie Daniels show on Saturday night, and I was asking you out in the lobby how tickets were going. People need to get their tickets, don't they?
Well, they do. I was there Saturday and Sunday and Monday, and I asked them about that, and they said, "Well, we have a few left," and then Monday and Tuesday we sold a lot of tickets. So evidently, in this market, people wait till the last minute. So
we're seeing that with the Avett Brothers too. We had a big rush at the beginning, and we're thinking now that things are going to really pick up, particularly with students and stuff, on Monday and Tuesday. But I think you're right. In this area, people wait till the last minute. But seeing Charlie, having a chance to see Charlie Daniels in an intimate setting like that's pretty cool. You got like 1,700 seats.
That's correct.
We
can hold about 1,500 seats, and then we have the boxes around, and so we've got.
So how do people get tickets? Is it rrtlive.com?
You can go there. You can call the phone number, which is on the website. It's 1-800-RRT-LIVE. I should have known that. Anticipated that question.
Just go to the website, rrtlive.com. Rrtlive.
Exactly. And you can see the schedule of the things we've got coming up.
Yeah, you got some other great shows too, right?
Well, we had Uncle Cracker scheduled in September. We got Hurricane Florence instead.
Yeah.
Instead
of Cracker, you got Florence.
Yeah, but he's coming on January the 19th. We have it's something we talked about last time I was here, was the Eagles tribute band.
Yeah, man.
We've got them scheduled on the 26th of January. And something
I'm going to be there, by the way. I love those guys.
I do, too. They're one of them. The Eagles is one of my favorite
But this tribute band, they're called On the Border. They were voted the number one Eagles tribute band in the country by Axis TV, and they did a special for Axis TV.
Yeah.
And then, of course, we had them here this summer down on the Town Common. Now you're going to have them there. And if we don't bring them back for our concert on the Common next year, I'll be skinned alive. So we're going to have to bring them back next year. But this is an opportunity to see them here in midwinter.
We have another group coming in February that I'm excited about, and it's the Highwaymen. And people looked at me and said, "Never heard of it." And they said, "Well, that was Waylon Jennings, Johnny Cash, Willie Nelson, and Kris Kristofferson."
Right.
And we have a tribute group that's doing the Highwaymen, and they've got a look-alike and a sing-alike, Waylon Jennings, Johnny Cash, and Willie Nelson. And they're going to be at our place on February the 9th.
I'm
looking forward to that one.
Very cool.
I'm looking
down your schedule here also. You've got the Alabama Blues Queen.
Yeah.
Deidra, the Alabama Blues Queen. Jason Michael Carroll, which a good country act. I think he grew up around Raleigh somewhere.
He did. He's going to be the opening act for Charlie Daniels.
Oh, this week?
Yeah. He'll be there. The show's going to start about 7 o'clock, and then Charlie Daniels will come on about 8.
And then you got Parmalee on December 8th?
Yeah, that's another one we talked about that we talked around a little bit. Yeah. I think we didn't have them signed at that time. But
you got them.
Yep.
They had 7,000 people here for Free Boot Friday for them. I mean, they had a big following here.
And then we're going to have we got the Embers?
Embers Christmas Show.
Yeah.
You got it on Thursday, December 13th. Well, ours is going to be here in Greenville on December 9th, but people can go see it twice here, or people up in Northeast will have an opportunity to see it.
Yep,
and I said earlier today, if you've never seen the Embers Christmas Show, I liken it every time to the old Andy Williams TV special, but Craig Willard is such a talent. And you get to see him seeing beach music when you go out and see the Embers, but this Embers Christmas Show gives him a chance to show a totally different side. I mean, he finishes the show, or he has the last 2 years, with A Birthday of a King. I mean, it's some of the sacred religious music that we grew up with for Christmas, but a lot of the fun Christmas songs that we grew up with. And and generally no beach music, although Craig gets in the mood every now and then to do a beach music encore.
He does.
So I don't know. You guys might get that up there on December 13th.
Yeah, I hope so. You know, Yvonne and I went to see it on see the Embers Christmas show at the Turnage Theater downtown Washington.
That's where I first saw it. Yeah.
That's a fun venue. It's,
yeah.
But, so absolutely. That was good.
All right, so lots of great stuff coming to Roanoke Rapids Theater, man. We got, you know, this has got to work for you. I hope it really does. This is a big deal for Eastern North Carolina, in my opinion.
It's been fun. I tell you, the people in that area, so many people come up to me and say, thank you for doing this. And,
sure.
And, you know, we're obviously, you know, our goal is to make a little money, but at the same time, I think we can help the community.
Yeah.
And I mean, that was sort of my philosophy in the restaurant business. If we make it good for the community, it's going to be good for us.
Yeah.
And it was.
Yeah. Charlie Daniels, this Saturday night, get your tickets, rrtlive.com, the Charlie Daniels Band. And it'll be a great weekend to see Charlie because, as you said, he's a big-time veteran supporter. So
yeah,
good luck with
sure.
it.
Thank you very
good
much,
to see
Henry.
You.
Good, great to
Tom
see you
Tom McClain
again.
From the
Thank
Roanoke
you.
Rapids Theater. And everybody go see Charlie Daniels this weekend.
Please.
And all the other shows. Go to rrtlive.com and see all the other great shows coming up. And the restaurant opens on Monday. So,
yep.
All right, good to see you, Tom. 14 in front of 9. We'll be right back. McGee's Got Sports.
You waited for year-end savings. Now it's finally here at Greenville Toyota. Camrys, only $179 a month. You don't want to miss these deals. Camrys, $179 during the year-end savings event at Greenville Toyota.
Carolina's greatest hits play all day on 107.9 WNCT.
Don't stop believing. Oh,
all your favorites. In the morning, Carolina's greatest hits play here.
WNCT.
This is the Pepsi for serious fans and serious eats. Oh, yeah, like Carolina pulled pork, carnitas, or Alberto's al pastor. Nice, Beto. This is the Pepsi for Sundays at the ballpark and days off at your favorite joint. Whatever you're craving, this is the Pepsi for you.
Stop by Moore's Old Time Barbecue and grab a Carolina Classic combo with a free 20-ounce Pepsi. Moore's Barbecue and Pepsi, Carolina Classics indeed.
Sometimes coming home can be a battle in itself. Our wounded warriors need everyone's support to meet the challenges they face every day. The USO provides every American a way to support them and their families.
What?
It's good to be back.
Join us. Visit USO.org to learn how you can make a difference in the lives of our wounded warriors. The USO. Until everyone comes home.
The ECU Foundation, in association with Airbanks Media, is proud to present the Avid Brothers, sponsored by the Carolina Panthers. The Avid Brothers, headlining concert for Hurricane Florence Relief, Minji's Coliseum, Tuesday, November 13th. Tickets are on sale now at ecutickets.net and by phone at 800-DIAL-ECU. Proceeds will be donated back to the people and organizations contributing to Hurricane Florence relief efforts. The Avid Brothers, brought to you by the ECU Foundation and Interbanks Media.
Don't wait. Get year-end savings now at Greenville Toyota. Corollas, $159 a month. RAV4s, $199. The wait is over and the deals won't last. It's the year-end savings event at Greenville Toyota, where our volume saves you money.
All right, here we go. Charlie Daniels and Roanoke Rapids on Saturday night, and this will be the highlight, no doubt.
The devil went down to Georgia. He was looking for a soul to steal. He was in a bind because he was way behind, and he was willing to make a deal. When he came across this young man sewing on a fiddle and playing it hot, and the devil jumped up on a hickory stump and said, boy, let me tell you what. I guess you didn't know it, but I'm a fiddle player too. And if you'd care to take a dare, I'll make a bet with you. Now, you play pretty good fiddle, boy, but give the devil his due. I bet a fiddle of gold against your soul, because I think I'm better than you. The boy said, my name's Johnny, and it might be a sin, but I'll take your bet you're going to regret, because I'm the best there's ever been. Johnny, rosin up your bow and play your fiddle hard, because hell's broke loose in Georgia, and the devil deals the cards. And if you win, you get this shiny fiddle made of gold. But if you lose, the devil gets your soul.
Charlie What a great song. I remember that so well. That was a crossover hit. It was played on country stations, pop stations. It was played everywhere. Did they play that in your neighborhood, Coach?
Absolutely. It was a hit.
And Charlie Daniels can play that fiddle, man.
Yeah, he can.
He's still getting it done. All right, Charlie Daniels live on Saturday night at Roanoke Rapids Theater. Go to rrtlive.com for tickets. All right, 10 minutes in front of 9. This segment of Talk of the Town brought to you by SilverCare, helping Greenville's area seniors for 25 years. Visit them at silvercareweb.com. We're going to do our Laugh Track replay with Jim Gaffigan coming up in a minute. But first, here's McGee on sports.
NFL action tonight. It has the 6-2 Panthers visiting the 5-2-1 Steelers. Pittsburgh, a 3.5-point favorite. Kickoff from Heinz Field set for 8:20, 7:20 airtime with pregame coverage here on 103.7 WTIB. So watch out and see if the Carolina can move to 7-2 with a win tonight. College football tonight, number 14, NC State hosts Wake Forest. Wolfpack are 4-5 overall, 3-2 in the ACC. Demon Deacons are 4-5 on the season, 1-4 in the league. Kickoff from Riley is set for 7:30. And former Dallas Cowboys wide receiver Dez Bryant has signed a one-year deal with the New Orleans Saints, joining a thin receiving core there in New Orleans.
All right, 8:51. It is coming up on 9 minutes in front of 9 o'clock. We are going to be live on tomorrow morning. We're going to be at Krispy Kreme, so we hope that everybody will come down and be a part of Krispy Kreme tomorrow morning. We're going to have, they're going to get the very first taste of their all-new Cinnamon Swirl Donut and S'mores Hot Chocolate. And while we're live tomorrow morning between 7 and 9, if you stop by and say you heard us on Talk of the Town, you're going to get a free Cinnamon Swirl Donut. Mm. And they're not going to be officially on sale until Monday, so you get a sneak preview. Don't miss this chance to try the Krispy Kreme's newest creation, the Cinnamon Swirl Donut. That sounds pretty good.
It sounds really good.
So come down tomorrow morning between 7 and 9, and you'll have an opportunity to get a Cinnamon Swirl Donut. Talk of the Town this morning on 103.7 WTIB and 96.3, the new Talk 96.3, the new home of Rush Limbaugh. And, of course, people down. I got a nice note from David Irwin, who's one of our loyal listeners, who said he was had to work down in Onslow County today. He left Greenville, carried us all the way down to Kinston on 103.7. He said when it started getting scratchy on 103.7, I flipped over to 96.3, and boom, you were there again. So if you're traveling south, Kinston's about the break-off point for 103.7 down on 11. You can get us good through Vanceboro on 103.7. Of course, the signal goes from the Virginia line out to the Outer Banks to Rocky Mount and all the way down to New Bern. A lot of times people down around the southern part of the market say, why is your signal not great on 103.7 down here? Well, it's because that we cover so much of northeastern North Carolina from our tower position. And then now with the new Talk 96.3, we get everything from New Bern almost to Wilmington, including Moorhead City, Jacksonville, Pamlico County, Jones County, Pender County, Duplin County on 96.3. You can hear all of our great talk programming now. We got another article in National Magazine yesterday, National Publication, Radio World, Radio Inc. magazine, ran a big story on the front page of their website for us yesterday. And the headline was something like IBX Media makes a dial position swap in Greenville. Well, it's not quite Greenville, but to them, it's the Greenville market. So that's why they said that. I want to remind you again that coming up today is the big day at Beauty Bar Medi Spa. Your opportunity to come and get questions answered about any of their treatments they're offering at Beauty Bar. This is their big Gatsby Affair party today from 11 to 7. It's all free. Come on in, 11 to 7. It's a party at Beauty Bar Medi Spa on Red Banks Road. Gentlemen, this is a great time to come in and get your wife a pre-Christmas gift, or just hold it until you give it to her on Christmas Day, because they're going to have the best prices of the year on some of their services. And, you know, for the lady that's got everything, a little Botox treatment won't hurt. So stand by and head over to Beauty Bar Medi Spa, 11 o'clock to 7 o'clock today. It's the big Gatsby Affair party. They're going to have refreshments on hand and great prices. All right, 5 minutes until the top of the hour at 9 o'clock. Let's do our laugh track replay right now. We had Jim Gaffigan, one of our favorites this morning, talking about this time of year, the autumn and the fall foliage and things like that. Here is a little laugh for you on the way to work with our laugh track with Jim Gaffigan. Coming.
Fall, people love fall. It's my favorite season. People that love fall, they go crazy for the foliage. They're like, oh, the foliage! Let's drive by the foliage! It's so beautiful the way the leaves die. They're so pretty right before they fall to their death. We think it's beautiful. It's the leaves hospice. It also helps that the leaves can't talk. If they could talk, they'd be like, ah! Give me chlorophyll! Why are these people driving by and smiling at me? We're rather insensitive to the leaves' tragedy. They die, they fall to the ground, we just rake them up. Kids, you want to jump on this pile of dead leaves? No? All right, I'll just light them on fire.
All right, that is Jim Gaffigan on the laugh track this morning. Thanks to Taco Tom from Roanoke Rapids Theater. Don't forget to get your tickets for Charlie Daniels, Roanoke Rapids Theater at rrtlive.com. Don't forget your Avett Brothers tickets. That is Tuesday night. Don't wait. Get your Avett Brothers tickets. You can get those at ecutickets.net. You're going to dodge a few raindrops tomorrow, but come on out and join us tomorrow morning at Krispy Kreme. We'll see you there. Have a great Thursday, everybody.
Save with low monthly payments on new Jeep here at East Carolina Chrysler Dodge Jeep.
It's the Black Friday sales event. Lease a new 2019 Jeep Cherokee for only $299 a month. With only $299 due at signing. Lease a new Jeep Grand Cherokee for only $399 a month. With only $399 due at signing. Or lease a new Jeep Wrangler for only $399 a month. With only $399 due at signing.
Across from the Cracker Barrel in Greenville.
Space, you can't run down to the store to buy parts. You have to improvise with what you have on your mission. Making is when there is something new that was not in existence at the beginning of the day.
Okay.
It's an incredible sense of accomplishment when you have made something. That's why I make. Now I want to hear why you make.
Share your own Why I Make story today. Visit whyimake.org.
Washington Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram is the truck dealer in Eastern North Carolina. We are overloaded with new Ram trucks, and we've discounted every one of them to move.
Save up to $12,000 in total savings on select Ram 1500 trucks right now at the Summer Clearance Event. And come test drive the all-new 2019 Rams that are now here in stock.
Visit us at WashingtonChrysler.com. Washington Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram. Drive a little to save a lot.
U.S. Cellular put towers where most others don't. So people can schedule a chiropractor visit out here. Or catch the game live way over here. Isn't that what you pay for? A stronger signal in the middle of anywhere.
Visit Real Wireless, your local U.S. Cellular authorized agent in Ahoskie, Williamston, and Windsor for the best deals in wireless and great service on a network that works in the middle of anywhere.
Come check out the all-new 2019 Ram. We have a huge selection to choose from here at East Carolina Chrysler Dodge Jeep.
Hurry in to the Black Friday sales event for huge rebates and super low lease payments on Ram trucks. Right now, get a total savings of $12,659 or lease a new 2019 Ram 1500 Crew Cab for only $379 a month with only $999 due at signing.
Across from the Cracker Barrel in Greenville.